It's Wednesday the 24th of June today, and with this beautiful blue sky at the back of us, we're going to have a look round Affinity Lancashire, or Freeport Fleetwood, you might know it as if you've been coming here as long as I have. Trouble is you can never get a good picture in the morning because the sun's in the wrong place, so you'll have to just make do with a slightly shaded view. Say good morning to the security guy on the door. Morning!
Good morning!
Please keep left, one-way system in place. And then we've got the hand sanitizers as well so that you can wipe your hands when you come in. Claire's accessories. That had been around when I was a little girl, you never have got me out of there. You can understand how it's a magnet for kids. There's one good thing about Affinity, I'll not keep calling it Freeport. There's one good thing about Affinity, there's plenty of space. And you'll notice that all the benches have gone. And that's because the benches are not actually supposed to be out for obviously health and safety reasons. Costa have got their tables and chairs missing because they're not allowed to trade as a cafe at the moment. So it's all very civilised. Now when I come to Affinity, I always go down to the bottom end of the mall and then walk back towards the door doing my shopping. Sort of backwards, as you might say. So that's what we're going to do this morning. So we're going to walk right round to the toilets at the other side of the marina and then we'll walk back. Oh, it's nice to be back. This is one of our regular haunts. This is somewhere where we shop as a family. It's handy to us to where we live, and it's good to be able to get from shop to shop to shop undercover without getting drowned if it's a bit of a poor day. I've got to say as well, can I just say, The Works has got to be my favourite shop. Oh, it's always expensive when I go in there. It's only, let's have a look what time it is. It's 11:05 on Wednesday morning, so they've only been open for about an hour. Which is why it's so quiet. So it tends to be people kind of coming for a purpose and then off in the morning, and then in an afternoon it's busy with people that are shopping for leisure. Still one or two shops closed, but you can see that by and large most things are open. I think the rest of them are probably getting themselves organised so that they can open when they've got the social distancing measures in place properly. So the baggage factory says open on the door, but yet it looks closed at the moment. Or is it open? No, there's nobody in. They must be just closed for the moment. Cadbury's shop's open, so that's an important one. If you've got my sweet tooth. Potter shop's closed at the moment. I'm sure they'll all be back in due course. So this is the children's play area. In fact, we'll take some photographs of this on the way back and we'll have a proper look at it. Because as a children's play area, it's always full of children. So it's not really, it's a bit frowned upon taking pictures of children in the playground. You end up with a stream of mothers and dads shouting at you. I'd have loved that. I mean, it's brilliant, isn't it? And there's even a little boat. Do you know, I never even noticed that little boat. Good, isn't it? It's usually full of kids and people enjoying it. The queue for Next, doubling back on itself because they open today, so obviously they're only allowing a small number of people in at once. I wonder if you can see through the window at Jolly Jacinta's. Maximum capacity in this store is 20 people. Interesting. Please do not come in if you are not well. I bet they're doing some dread this morning. So this is Jolly Jacinta's, which is the children's soft play area, and obviously this is closed at the moment because it's a children's play area. But I'll see if I can get the camera right up to the window and show you. Can you see the view inside? It's not ideal, but you can more or less see it. Can you see the soft play things? It's good. When I came before lockdown, I popped in and took some photographs, and it's a really nice space. The space at the end for parents to sit as well under normal circumstances. So that's open normally Monday to Wednesday, 10 while 6. Mr. Magpie's trilling up his tree. I can hear him, but I can't see him. So we'll go right round here because we can have a nose around here. I can remember coming one day and we were watching fish in the marina. Don't know what they were. Be interesting to see if there's any today because it's quite warm and the water will be warm. This marina used to be full of boats at this end. Little sailing boats and yachts and things. You can see some of them at that end, look. We'll double back round there and I'll show you when we've finished looking round. But I believe the reason why it's so empty is that ABP are not dredging it any longer, so the boats can't actually get in. In fact, look at that, there's a seagull there on a nest. You see it? I'm just zooming in. Let me see if I can. The sun's very bright. It's right in the centre of Short. I'm sure that's a nest it's sat on. It is. Wow. Off to see cormorants as well. This pontoon thing, it lifts and drops as the water comes in and out. And you often see cormorants sat on the top of those metal poles. So that's the marina. And then at the other side of that is the next section of the fish dock. And Jacinta is moored at that side of the dock. So we'll take a look down there as well. That might be tomorrow's video. Right, we'll go down here and I'll show you around this corner. So if you've not been to Affinity for a while, you might not have seen all these houses. They've been built, I would say, over the last possibly 4 or 5 years. This block of toilets is closed at the moment, but there is another block of public toilets at the entranceway. So this is Harbourside Village, and it's accessed from the A585 down there somewhere. Might have got my geography a bit wrong, but that at the other side of that backs onto the Fleetwood Marsh Nature Reserve. And this, let me just drop my camera through the slots. That little footbridge was built as part of the development so that people that live on that side of the harbour can get to Fleetwood on foot. So here at the moment we are right on the end of that little cul-de-sac where McDonald's is. I don't think you'll be able to see it from here. Bet these two have got babies, they're shouting at me. So that little road, can you see? That little road that way is to McDonald's and the little entrance road to Affinity. And this is the old dock gate, which used to open and shut to let boats across, and I feeling. I think that yellow thing there, that is one of the bollards that they used to tie the ropes round. I think that might be this might be something to do with the winding gear for the ropes. Oh yeah, and this look. Let's slot it through again. This here is the matching side to the other side of the dock gate. So that is what they can shut across if they need to either keep a flood out or keep water in. There you go, you see, you thought it was just shops, didn't you? And that's relevant as well, but I can't quite remember why. I'm sure somebody will tell me. If you do know, pop a comment below and then we'll all know for next time. So it's a lovely view from here. This used to be a cafe, I don't know whether you can remember or not. And then there was a shoe shop next door. And you see, I know all the shoe shops. Oh, there's a fish. I told you they've got fish. Can you see it? Hey! There's obviously some more. I've got absolutely no idea what it is. At a guess, I'd say it's a dogfish. But that's no more than a guess, because I know we get a lot of them around here. Boy, I'm pleased to see that. Just shows you how clean the water is though, doesn't it? You see, you might think it's mucky and it's not. Oh, no, I don't think it is a dogfish. Anyway, if you know what the fish is, put a comment in the comments below. So it's, as I was saying, it's a lovely view from here as well, because you sort of stand here and look back across the harbour. And when I first moved here, I can remember standing on this corner and saying, if you were in Cornwall, if you were in Falmouth or somewhere like that, you'd be raving about how lovely this place is. So why does nobody rave about how nice Fleetwood is? And that really was a lot of why we started doing Visit Fylde Coast in the first place, because we love where we'd moved to and we wanted everybody else to see this amazing place. Got a parent up here watching me, can you see it? I don't know whether it's Mr. Seagull or Mrs. Seagull, but I can hear the babies tweeting. We're not going to get to see them. So much for putting spikes on the side of the building. Right, so we'll walk back down here and have another look. They've got social distancing on in all the shops, queues outside the doors, limitations on how many people can go in. So even though it's very quiet and it's very different to the shopping experience that you would have had before when you came here, it all feels very safe. You might have seen me, I look like I'm in disguise. I've got my sunglasses on and my face mask. You might have caught a glimpse of me when I looked in the window at Jolly Jacinta. But you certainly don't think I'm doomed, I'm going to end up catching something. I mean, even where there's a queue, it's not on Sports Direct proportions, and it's all being very carefully managed. I mean, look at that. It's good. Excellent. 10 out of 10. I can't see any more fish here. Right, we'll go back this way. It's a lovely day. I looked at the thermometer in the car just before I got out to come in here. And it was 19 and a half degrees, and that was at 11 o'clock. So it's gonna be boiling today. It's gonna be enough to roast you. It's nice to see things coming back to life. It's nice to see, even if we've got to do things in a bit of a weird way, that it's not like it was in March when everything was absolutely closed and silent and quiet. It's just like a, it's like a scene from a film, isn't it, when you see all the shops, so very odd. Very odd. But 3 months has absolutely flown, and we've been a while getting to this point, so it'll be over before you know it. It'll be this time next year and we'll all be looking back and saying, can you remember when we'd all got to stop in for coronavirus? Little queue at the cafe, look. That's Katie's. That's the family run Fleetwood business that does lovely cakes and all the nice kind of things that I like to eat and shouldn't do. I keep meaning to take my old iPad in there and see if you can get it going again. It just died on me. It just one day stopped. You see the shops though, they're all very, taking the tables out, there's no seating facilities. So all in all, we're impressed. Might even get my mum to come here for an hour. I think my dad's decided that he's stopping in until about 20:30. But you certainly don't feel like you're gonna catch anything. So that's the exit that we came out of. Or should I say the exit that we came into. So all in all, I think that's a good experience, that. Plenty of information about, look. Nice, safe shopping experience. So you have a nice day. Don't forget to subscribe. We're nearly at 1,000 subscribers. And we need to get to 1,000 subscribers ASAP. So please, please, please help. You have a nice day, you take care and stay safe, and we'll see you soon. Bye!